Hey guys, I had a question today. Troy Carpenter asked, basically, how do you use Kontakt and set up the 8 ins and 8 outs in Bitwig? Well, challenge accepted, Troy. Let's see here. I didn't actually have Kontakt before this, and it's foolish because I just downloaded the demo and it's so cool. I keep hearing about it. I've been making do with other stuff, but I think I'm totally going to buy it at this point. Money, cash flow is a little low these days, so we'll see. Hopefully my music career takes off and to pay for some of this stuff. So anyway, I've created a bunch of tracks. One's a MIDI track or an instrument track, that, and I named it Kontakt. You'll see I don't have anything loaded on here yet. I created 3 audio tracks. I'm going to delete the audio from in here, and I put them in a group called From Kontakt. Okay, and then 3 more instrument tracks. They don't have any devices loaded on them, but they each have different MIDI data. Okay, and I called that To Kontakt. So, firstly, click on Kontakt and load up Kontakt. Let's see. I'm going to choose 8 out. Wait for that puppy to load. Okay, so again, I just have the demo here, but I'm going to load up the C3 Blues, the cello ensemble, and the kalimba. Okay. Gonna minus these up. Okay, presets/batch configuration. Batch functions, clear output section and create 1 individual channel for each loaded instrument. Bada bing. Okay, so I'm gonna click on this guy. MIDI channel is receiving from A1. Beautiful. From A2. Beautiful. Kalimba from A3. Perfect. I believe that's about all you have to do in there. If you click this thing, this is the chains. Click that, add missing chains. Okay, that's important. That's on your Kontakt plugin on your instrument channel. Okay, so now we're going to go to the To Kontakt where I've written in some bullshit MIDI data right here. Instrument 1, you're going to click on the output, plugins, Kontakt, Kontakt 5. And see that number? That's 1. Same thing here. Output, plugins, Kontakt, Kontakt 5, 2. And outputs, plugins, Kontakt, Kontakt 5, and 3. Okay, great. Now, from Kontakt, this is what we're going to record on. Click the audio channel. Click the input. Kontakt. Kontakt 5 chains. And we'll do C3 Blues pre. This one here. The second track from Kontakt, Kontakt 5 change. We'll take it from the cello pre. And this guy, input, Kontakt 5 chains and kalimba. If you don't have the chains here, it's because you didn't go to Kontakt, click this, and click create change. Okay. Now, in theory, this channel will play into, I forget what it was, the cello maybe? Or the C3 Blues, and then this one into the cellos or whatever, and that one into the other thing, okay? So, I'm gonna record arm all these, hit record, and see what happens. Isn't that just a hit song right there? Okay, so if we solo this and listen. Yeah, C3 Blues, listen to this guy. Cello section. Kalimba. So this channel has gone into Kontakt and then come out recorded as the kalimba. This channel has gone in here recorded as the cello, and this track has gone into Kontakt and come out as the C3 Blues. I hope that answers your question, Troy. If it doesn't, let me know. I'll keep tinkering. In the meantime, I'm gonna go basically scrounge money together and buy this damn thing because it's pretty sweet. And then it looks like also I'm going to have to buy yet another external hard drive because 43 gigs worth of samples is nothing to scoff at. Okay, guys, I hope that clears up something for you. If not, let me know, okay? I want to answer your questions properly. If that didn't do it for you, then let me know. And so just a summary, the important thing to know here is that inside Kontakt, you've done the batch configuration. Again, that's batch functions, clear output section, and basically make an individual track for each one. Go in here, make sure the MIDI channels are all on different channels. So that's 1, 2, and 3, okay? Click this, you'll be here. Click that guy, the chains, and create the missing chains, okay? When you're with the outputs, make sure you are receiving the audio from the proper source, which is the chains. So it'll be pre or post, depending if you want it before the fader or after. I would say before, because then you can mix it after. And then, of course, the MIDI data going to Kontakt. Make sure you're setting the output to Kontakt 5 through the plugins, right? And you're choosing, you're telling it which channel that you want it to play on according to which channel you've set inside Kontakt. Okay? All right, kids. Take care.